Let's summarize all of the horizontal transformations. So changes to f of x inside the grouping symbol of the function notation, they cause horizontal changes. And thus they affect the x values of the graph. So recall that when we did the horizontal reflection about the y-axis, I think we used the square root function. And so when we wrote y equals the square root of negative x, this is a horizontal reflection. And we multiplied the y values, I mean, excuse me, the x values multiplied by negative 1. When we did a horizontal shift, I believe we used the absolute value function to show that. But the trick was is that this is really a shift left, because when it reads the absolute value of x plus 2, it's actually a shift left by 2 units. And the action we took was subtract 2 from the x values. And then we also had stretches and compressions in the horizontal direction, and I do believe we also used the absolute values. So when we had a number that was between 0 and 1, like y equals the absolute value of 1/2 x, this is actually the opposite of what we think, in that we have a wider graph, so the x values got larger. So this is called a horizontal stretch. Because c is between 0 and 1, 1/2 is between 0 and 1, and we multiplied x values by 1/1, which is really multiplying the x values by 2.